of, a car out of one. I pray this devil died and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come Yashala.
Come
Yashala.
Come Yashala.
I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this, but the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
That brother said, he hold themselves not guilty, man.
Right.
Read that part again, man. Who oppress or slay them and hold themselves not guilty.
Hold themselves not guilty. Meaning it's his job to oppress our people.
Right.
And he takes himself to court.
Right.
And looks at himself. This is what you got, this is what our people got to understand. Well, a white man goes to court having committed a crime.
Right.
He's going to court to face another white man.
Right.
And the white man look at another white man as himself.
Right.
And he look at himself and say, well, I can understand why you murdered everybody. You
right.
had a bad day, not
right.
guilty. I can understand why you shot that man 15 times in the back as he screamed, I got my hands up. I can understand, not
right.
guilty.
Right.
He finds himself not guilty. But when you go to the courtroom, you are guilty in his eyes because you and him not the same.
Right.
Like, we are different people all together, man.
Right.
That's something very important. That's why we must have our own court.
Right.
With our own judges.
Right.
With our own everything, man. We
right.
can't go to the white man seeking for him to do right by us.
Right.
Like, he gonna hold himself not guilty.
Right.
But us who are not white men, we guilty to him automatically.
Right.
An unborn black baby inside of that mother is already guilty.
Right.
That's why they telling sisters to abort the baby.
Right.
The baby got people trying to kill it before it breathes on its own.
Yeah, right.
The whole world is against a black baby. While it's inside of their mother still being formed, the world is already saying kill him. Put him in jail. Be a problem. Make sure he don't have a neighborhood to live in.
Right.
Make sure there is no job where his parents can work. Make sure we destroy his family. Make sure that that relationship is gone between the mother and father.
Right.
We already got a target on us. That's why the brother is saying our people are at war.
Right.
They don't do this to any other race of people,
right.
man.
Right.
He not gonna look at himself. Thank you, sister. Thank you, sister, man. He not gonna look at himself, man, and say, I want to put my own son in jail. He gonna say, I can understand my son made this mistake, and I can forgive my son. Like, that's what he gonna say.
Right.
Our people got to learn to forgive your own people.
Right.
Forgive another black man. A white man will forgive another white man. Learn to forgive your people. We can't forgive the white man and forgive black people. We got to learn to love each other. We got to consolidate our love that we have for each other.
Right.
We're gonna have to start looking at another black man like his life is important.
Right.
Before I stick a gun in your face and murder or rob you, I'm gonna have to think about you like this is myself I'm
right.
killing, man.
Right.
This is a brother like me, I can't kill him.
Right.
I need him to make children, I can't kill his son.
Right.
I'm gonna, my son gonna need his son,
right.
cause it's white people hunting us.
Right.
I'm gonna need his son so that my daughter gonna need him to have that son.
Right.
Cause my daughter gonna need a husband.
Right.
But if I kill all the brothers and all the brothers kill each other and all the sisters kill each other, we back to square one. As a matter of fact, we in a damn negative. Cause now we out of half of our family, we done all killed each other. Read that again, man. I want y'all to feel this for a second, man. Read that verse again. That verse again, man. Their own shepherds pity them not. The Lord is trying to tell our people something. It'd be Zechariah, was it 11 and 5? Zechariah 11 and 5. Like, the Lord is saying, our own shepherds don't pity us, man.
Right.
Like, the people that are set up as the leaders, that everybody who is black, like the black leaders that everybody recognizes and look to as a leader, they don't have any pity on our people.
Right.
Like, think about that for a second, man. How can you be the leader of a people and you can't feel the pain that they're going through?
Right.
Like, you don't have any pity on their people. Like, read what the Lord, this is what God want our people to see this. Read that.
Zechariah chapter 11, verse 5. Zalakia, verse 3. There is a voice of the howling of the shepherd.
You wonder why the ISUPK is on the streets yelling like this, opening the Bible, man. God said there's a voice of the howling of the shepherds, man. You ever heard a wolf howl? You heard an animal howl out loud? We are speaking like this, man, because we are the shepherds that God set up to lead our people, man. We the men that the Lord set up to watch over the lives of our people, man. That's why the Lord had to put this here, man. People that actually care and see the hell and the suffering that black people is going through. How can you sit silently like that if you love black people?
Right.
How can you watch black people be murdered like this in every city and not open your mouth, man?
That's right.
How could you sit in your big mansion, sitting with all of this wealth and money, knowing how your people is getting murdered and killed and starving to death and being abused and trashed in America like that?
That's
why the Lord had to say that. Keep reading.
For their glory is spoil.
For what?
Their glory is spoil.
What is your glory, man? What is the glory the Bible is talking about, man? The glory of our people is spoiled, man. We is a wonderful and a glorious people, man. We the people that built this country from the ground up and got absolutely nothing for it.
Right.
And the people that got the benefit of it opened their mouth as if they put their forth their hand to do some damn work to build America. It was slave money and slave labor and slave crops that built Portsmouth and Norfolk, Virginia and Chesapeake and all of these cities was built by slavery.
Right.
It was black people that built these cities, man.
Right.
It was black people that made these ports important, man. Without slaves, there is no tea. There is no tobacco products. There is no cotton. There are no crops that the settlers and the colonists are going to eat, man.
Right.
There is no houses being built without blacks and Hispanics, man. Without the inventions that black people made in America, there is no traffic light. There is no light bulb. There is no fountain pen, no refrigerator, radiator, icebox, heater, AC unit. There is no cell phone or video game cartridge without black people. There is no luggage, no potato chip, fried chicken, none of that without black people. Everything that made this place great and wonderful was came from our people. And they absolutely hate us for it. Like, that's what the Lord want our people to realize. Keep reading.
A voice of the roar of young lions.
The Lord send lions out, man. The Lord send young lions out, man. Contrary to them broke back preachers that our people been listening to, thinking that they men of God, man. The Lord is a man of war. That's why the Bible, that's why the brother here is telling our people that we in a state of war.
Right.
Our people have not been raised to understand that we are at war.
Right.
That it's a warfare going on against our people,
right,
and there is no sideline.
Right.
Babies are not exempt. They're telling people to kill our babies.
Right.
Grandma is not exempt. Old ladies are not exempt. Children are not exempt. The white man go to school, shoot up his own children. You think he care about our black children?
Right.
You think he care about our grandfather? They just found another brother hanging from a tree in Mississippi last week.
Right.
Another brother they found the previous month hanging from a tree in Mississippi.
Right.
You understand? They found a sister hacked to pieces in the damn, in the park in New York, man. They locked some white boy, stabbed the brother to death, some homeless brother. He stabbed the brother to death with a sword about 30 times, man. Our people not realizing we being hunted. That's why the Lord sent us out here, man. Read that.
For the pride of Jordan is spoiled.
Our pride is spoiled, man. A spoil is when there's a war and you lose the war. And the people that win get to take whatever they want from the losers, man. Well, our people have been at war and we have lost the war. That's why they're able to take our cities and neighborhoods, man. Take our sons and make them drug dealers and murderers, man.
Right.
Take our daughters and tell them to commit abortions and murder our babies, man.
Right.
Take our women and turn them into whores, man. That's what's been happening. Our people is a spoil of war. We behind enemy lines right now, man. We in captivity. We're not free here.
Right.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the Lord want our people to gather ourselves together, man. That's the only way we're going to have protection from this destruction, man. Read on. Verse 5.
Matter of fact, read for.
Thus saith the Lord, my God.
The Lord what?
My God. God.
The everybody's God.
My God.
The Arab's God.
My God.
The white man's God.
My God.
The African's God.
My God.
The Asian's God.
My God.
The God of this Bible is only the God of one race of people, man.
Right. What?
The God of this Bible is not the God that the Arabs serve. They have their own gods. That's what our people don't realize. Every race of people has a God and a culture based around that God that is to promote and unite their race of people.
Right.
Islam cannot do that for our people. We've been Muslims for years. It hasn't stopped any murder or drug overdoses. Christianity can't do that. We've been Christians since we got off the slave ship. It hasn't stopped any murders or drug overdoses, man. Prison full of Muslims and Christians right now. You understand? We gonna have to turn back and serve the Lord, man. We don't.
Feed the flock of the slaughter.
God said, feed the flock of the slaughter, man. God sent his shepherds out here to feed the flock of the slaughter. What is the flock of the slaughter, man? The flock of the slaughter is black people, man. Our people being killed on a daily because we don't realize what's going on in America, man.
Right.
We don't realize that we're being hunted, man. We don't realize that this society that's set up over the backs and on top of our people is here to destroy us, and that you're supposed to do your part to build your own society.
Right.
You're supposed to keep God's laws to build our society.
Right.
Where it's illegal for a black man to murder each other.
Right.
It's illegal to murder our babies. It's illegal for us to have sex with a sister and throw her away. Or your woman to leave you and put you on child support.
Right.
Or you to get rich and go leave the sister in the ghetto and go have sex with a nasty Kardashian whore in Hollywood after you done threw and ran through all the damn sisters in the hood, man. We're supposed to build our society where our babies is safe to play in the streets.
Right.
Because it's lions on patrol that will protect them, man.
Right.
We don't have anybody to protect and defend our people. That's why we getting killed, man.
Right.
That's why they able to devour our people, man. But the Lord raising up men to protect our people, man.
Right.
The ISUPK is a full-fledged army, man. If you don't know about the ISUPK, pull out your phone and Google us, man.
Right.
Pull out your phone and look up the Passover, man, we just had, man.
Right.
It's time for our people to come back to our nation. You know you don't like that damn job you got, man. You know you hate getting up in the middle of the night to go to your job, man.
Right.
You know you hate having to leave your kids with some damn stranger while you gotta sit in the white man's office and use your business voice.
Right.
Use your business voice, talk white. Can't talk how you normally talk. You understand? We constantly under oppression in this place. That's what the Lord want our people to realize. If you came and built your own nation, which is what the Lord set up in the ISUPK, we wouldn't have these problems, man. Or we could greatly decrease the effects that they have on our people because we would be united and the Lord would be with us. We don't.
Whose possessors? Slay them.
Whose what?
Possessors. Slay them.
Our people have to understand we're not free in America, man. The language that you're speaking belongs to our slave master.
Right.
I'm speaking English right now because the white man who came from England enslaved my forefathers.
Right.
I can speak Spanish because the white man that came from Spain enslaved my forefathers.
Right.
I can speak Portuguese because the white man who came from Portugal enslaved our brothers, the tribe of Asher down in Brazil, man. Our brothers speak French because the white man from France enslaved our brothers and sisters, man, in the Caribbean.
Right.
We under the possession of our enemies, man. These people that rule over us are not our friends. They don't look at us as equal. Don't you know USA Today published a story, man, that said that a black family, two-parent home where both the parents work and make good salary and good jobs, they said that a two-parent black family makes less than a white family that only got one parent. Make considerably less money. With you and your wife working together, y'all still don't make the money that one white man make by himself.
Right.
Where is this equality that the church be telling us about? Where is this it's not about race that they're telling us about, man? They run game on our people, man. That's why the Lord got us out here roaring in these streets to wake our people up, man. Keep reading.
And hold themselves not guilty.
And when they kill our people, they hold themselves not guilty. Read on. Mike Brown, man. That's why that white man that killed Mike Brown got free. They do what, brother?
What did they do?
Hold themselves not guilty.
You watched the video of a white man murdering Eric Garner. Six white men strangled that brother to death as he screamed, "I can't breathe." He already on his back. It's six people standing on top of him. all of these things going on, they continue to kill that brother. And that chokehold that they use has been illegal by the NYPD New York, illegalized that chokehold since 1992.
Right.
And they used it and murdered that brother, and they did what?
And hold themselves not guilty.
We never gonna get a guilty verdict, man. One guilty white man verdict isn't gonna make up for the murder of 99 million black people during the transatlantic slave trade.
Right.
We gonna have to change our lives and position the Lord so that the Lord can give us justice.
Right.
Why? Because the white man that's going to kill us is what?
And hold himself not guilty.
He's never going to say, I'm guilty of being a murderer. What murderer says, yeah, I did the murderer, come on, put me in jail. Like the white man is an animal. There is no justice inside of him. We can't get justice from those people. We got to turn to the Lord to get justice. The problem is, our people have never been taught how to call on the Lord properly, man.
Right.
Looking in the mirror saying, Jesus, 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 five times like Candyman or Beetlejuice is not how you call on the name of the Lord, man.
Right.
The Christian church teach us a bunch of magic and fairy tales, man.
Right. Right.
Calling on the name of the Lord, if I say, man, why you playing games with my name, man? That don't mean you saying my name over and over and playing a game with it. That mean what? That mean you disrespecting my name. You saying something evil about me. You saying something that's not true. But to call on the name of Christ, to call on the name of the Lord, is you stating his reputation, man. This Bible is a black man's book. It don't have nothing to do with white people, man. The white man is the villain in the Bible. The white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of in the Bible, man. That's what our people don't realize. Our people have been taught to pattern our lives after the white man. That's why our marriages fail. Our relationships fail. We end up raising kids by ourselves. We end up in jail. They end up taking the whole goddamn city from black people. What country do you know that'll take a whole city from a race of people? Like, how do you evict an entire city of people in the richest place on the planet, America? What purpose would there be to kick the poorest people in the country out of their poverty-stricken place to live? Why would you take that from them, man? Because these people are our enemies. And picking up a gun is not how you fight the white man. Saying to hell with the white man is not how you fight the white man. You fight the white man by stop serving his culture. By stop being a Christian like the white man. Stop being a Democrat and a Republican like the white man. Stop joining in his votes and his protests, man. Stop joining this white man's military, man. Stop selling drugs to your brother. That's for the white man. The white man sell drugs and build a government. Brothers sell drugs to their own people in their own neighborhood and become dangerous, man.
Right.
End up getting killed by your own people you selling drugs with, man.
Right.
Ain't no future in that. Ain't no retirement in that.
Right.
If you have a successful drug operation, that means that you done turned your people into drug addicts.
Right.
And they're gonna make horrible drug addict decisions, like
right.
murder, like rape, like stealing, and they're gonna end up in jail. We gonna end up hurting each other. Who benefits from that?
Right.
When the police kick in your door, they're gonna take all the cars you got. If anybody else live in the house, they going to jail.
Right.
If there's any kids in there, they going to foster care.
Right.
We already can't keep a goddamn place to live as it is. They're getting ready to gentrify Norfolk.
That's
what did we gain from that?
No.
What did we get?
No.
All we did was further hurt our people, man. That's why we got to be directed that the men the Lord set up. That's why the Lord sent the ISUPK out here, man.
Right.
Our people in a never-ending cycle of trying to survive.
That's
Don't you know life was not supposed to be about survival? God didn't make life so that you can pay bills and work till you got sick, and then you use the rest of your money that you saved up and your insurance trying to get your health back after you can't work anymore. God ain't set life up like that, man. That is slavery. You're not supposed to have to pay a man for water to drink. You're not supposed to have to pay a man for a place to live. Your father's supposed to have places to live that he give to you when he die. We don't have it because the white man who possesses us murdered our fathers and stole the land. We don't have it because the white man is going to give money to other white men to put up $30 million to gentrify Newport News and Norfolk. That's how we live. So guess what? If you bought your house, the rest of your people that don't own the house gonna get put out the city. And when the white man come in the city, the property value gonna rise and the property taxes gonna rise. And when the property taxes rise in an area that's already poor, the people that's poor, that got what little crumb they were able to struggle to get, they can't afford the property taxes and the state come take the house any damn way. And then you hear the community on the commercial, would you like to make money flipping houses in the Newport News area? Would you like to flip houses in Norfolk? Come to my seminar at such and such Baptist church next Sunday, and I'll teach you how to make money flipping houses. And then the white man's economy booms and we all become homeless. Like, these people are animals that rule over us. And the only protection that you have, I'm gonna give you this scenario, man. If there was a pit bull running loose around these streets right now, and that pit bull got on your trail, and that pit bull was chasing you, could you turn around and talk to that pit bull and say, Mr. Pit Bull, I know you bad, you got it, I don't know what I did, please don't bite the hell out of me. Would that dog listen?
Yes, sir.
If you was in the jungle and there was a lion chasing you, you turn around and say, lion, you got it, man. You got it, lion. I can't see you in no capacity, you the man. Is that lion gonna spare your life?
No.
Our people have been taught to believe that this animal, the white man, who dropped bombs out the sky, who poisons the water, who poisons the air, who murders for fun, who extinct species of animals, who execute babies and call it and pass a damn law to make it okay, who put poison in a community and do chemical warfare on every level, how are we going to expect that this man would ever do right by our people? He's a worse animal than the lion. The lion's supposed to be that way. Well, God created the white man to be the devil that the Bible speaks of. And our people have to learn how to equip ourselves and our family to stand against the wiles of the devil. This is what they don't teach us in church, man.
That's right.
You can't sing our problems away, man.
That's right.
Nobody out-sing black people, man. We can't sing, dance, box, play enough basketball, play enough football, smoke enough weed, sell enough dope, turn enough tricks. Nothing that we've done has been able to solve this problem that we have, which is the white man's foot on our neck.
That's right.
Except turning back to serve the Lord.
Right.
That's the only hope that we have. We tried everything else, man.
That's right.
Keep reading.
And who possess to slay them and hold themselves not guilty. And they that sell them say.
Hold on, and they that do what?
Sell them.
They that sell them. Why does it say sell them in the Bible, man? Don't you know these Christian preachers and these leaders like Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson? Don't you know that they work with the white man and teach them how black people operate?
That's right.
That they work and they help white people understand the way that black people think.
That's right.
So that they can smile in black people's face.
That's right.
And get black people's trust.
That's right.
Like Barack Obama did.
That's right.
Like Al Sharpton did.
That's right.
Like Martin Luther King did. Like Jesse Jackson did. So that they can get black people's trust. And they can do what?
Sell them.
They sell our people, man.
Right.
They sell our people. You understand?
That's right.
They sell our people. Like you would sell water, or you would sell lemonade, or you sell dinners, or you would sell a car. They sell our people out, man.
Right.
We didn't get any drugs in the community before Reverend Al Sharpton.
That's right.
He worked to get crack and heroin in the black community.
That's right.
Every black community in this country.
That's right.
We didn't have any abortion clinics before Reverend Jesse Jackson wanted to become president and took millions of dollars from Planned Parenthood and set abortion clinics up in the black neighborhood.
Right.
They sell our people, man.
Right.
They sell our people. And what else?
So them say, blessed be the Lord.
What do they say?
Blessed be the Lord.
The people that are selling us are religious people, man. These is good, wholesome Christians that's selling us, man. These is people that believe that God loves everybody, that race doesn't matter, that you're going to die and go to heaven. They believe in Christmas and Mother's Day and Father's Day, Memorial Day and Thanksgiving, but they don't believe in loving black people. That's why we got to turn away from these people and come to the people the Lord set up in the ISUPK, man. Right. Keep reading.
For I am rich.
For what?
I am rich.
T.D. Jakes.
I am rich.
Ruffalo Donald.
I am rich.
Jesse Jackson.
I am rich.
Martin Luther King.
I am rich.
Al Sharpton.
I am rich.
Ben Carson.
I am rich.
Steve Harvey.
I am rich.
These is traitors to our people, man.
Right.
These rich pastors don't give a damn about black people getting ready to be put out of an entire city.
No, they don't.
They don't give a damn. Have you seen them out here?
What?
Call your aunt. Call grandma on the phone. Sunday afternoon, after she get out of church, and ask her that pastor mentioned about everybody getting ready to be evicted from Norfolk and Newport News. Ask her. See if the pastor warned them.
The Lord set watchmen up to give our people warning.
That's right.
It's 1,000 churches everywhere. Church there, church at the end of that block, church at the end of that block, churches everywhere.
That's right.
They not the men that God set up.
That's right.
They work for the white man. They don't work for black people.
Right.
We don't.
And their own shepherds.
And what?
Their own shepherds.
Their own shepherds. Own black men just like us that grew up in the ghetto. Feel this for a second, man. So, like, if I could, brother, I could say something for a minute, man. Feel this for a second. O.J. Simpson. Not O.J. I'm not going to use O.J., man. Their own shepherds, man. The people that you lead, that are leading you, they don't pity you.
That's right.
They don't pity a black man.
Right.
Don't you know that Ben Carson grew up in public housing just like a lot of black people? And when he got rich with the gift that the Lord blessed him with to do surgery, he stood on the Senate floor and said to cut the damn Section 8 budget for black
That's
people.
Right. He did. Sure did.
Like, he don't have pity
That's right.
for black people that was in the same situation that he was in. How could you turn on your people like that, man? How could you not pity your own brother suffering the same thing that you suffered?
Because of this man, we're not his brother no more.
That's a traitor, man.
That's right.
That's an evil man. That's a Christian man.
That's right.
That race don't matter to him.
That's
and because
right.
race doesn't matter, you don't matter.
That's right.
You understand? That's why the Lord put that there, man. That's an evil thing, man. Read that again.
That's right.
And their own shepherds pity them not. Their own shepherds pity them not, man. How could you sit and watch our black people struggling and starving and suffering?
Right.
Our sisters is trying to keep their sons out of the streets, their daughters from doing wrong, man,
right.
and gonna bring them into church to learn about God. And these disgusting preachers gonna molest these kids, man.
Right.
What kind of bastard would do that? Knowing how poor black people are,
right, right.
knowing our families are destroyed,
right.
knowing mama raising the kids by themselves,
yeah.
knowing grandma end up with custody of the kids when the parents end up in jail or dead, knowing all that we suffering, what kind of monster would molest the damn kids, man?
Right.
And then they gonna turn and blame the children and say they the problem after they done destroyed them, man. The
That's
Christian
right.
church is the house of Satan, man. What you say, sis?
Preach, baby.
Damn right, man. That's an evil thing, man. That's an evil thing, man. To put a burden like that on some child, man. Because you a disgusting animal that can't control your lust. You won't go molest some kid, man. You won't go rape some baby, man. Like, that's a damn animal, man. Man, you right, sister.
And
that's right. You can't control unless you know Jesus. But here's the problem, though. Our people can't learn about Jesus without coming where the people. That's right, sister. We're going to teach it, man. Our people have to be taught. And what Jesus said was that God want us to keep his laws, statutes, and commandments, man. And the same laws in the Bible that say not to eat pork, they also say not to rape a woman, man.
That's
not
right.
to rape a child, man.
That's
not
right.
to force somebody to have sex with you, man.
That's right.
against God in the Bible.
That's
a death penalty offense, man.
Right.
If we had a righteous society, we don't have that in the ISUPK, man. You understand? You going taking your babies to church, man. You putting them in jeopardy, man.
Right.
You coming to ISUPK, we don't have that, man. We don't have that, man. We don't have that, man. I know that the pastor don't open his mouth and say, y'all stop molesting these kids, man. Y'all stop hurting black people, man. Y'all stop destroying black women, man. Y'all stop destroying black children, man. Y'all turning them into horrible drug addicts molesting them, man. You're turning them into horrible, violent animals when you abuse them, man. I ain't never heard no preachers say that, man. The only people that say that are the prophets of God in the ISUPK, man. What good are you if you can speak a wonderful song, but you can't save the lives of your babies, man? Everybody should abandon these Christian churches, man. The most dangerous place in the entire black community, man. If not for the Christian preacher teaching our people to break God's laws, the same way you learn about Christmas and happy birthday as a baby, before you knew what the hell a birthday was, sitting in front of a cake on fire, scared to death as a one-year-old, you would learn not to smoke before you knew what smoking was. You would learn not to murder before you knew what murder was. You would learn that sex was marriage before you knew what sex was. You would learn not to hate your brother before you knew what it meant to have a brother. You would learn what God said before you got to learn what the white man said from the devil.
That's right.
And you damn right, sister. And you damn right. And
and honor thy mother and father, man. Honor thy mother and father means when your mother and father get sick and they can't feed themselves, that you feed them.
Right.
Not give them a Mother's Day card. That's against the Lord.
That's
but
right.
Mommy needs you to feed her when she don't remember how old she is.
That's
she
right.
don't remember what city she in.
That's right.
She can't wash her clothes like you couldn't wash your clothes.
That's
your
right.
daddy
That's
can't
right.
see and don't know what he doing like you didn't know what you were doing when
yeah,
you was a baby
right.
running in the damn street.
Right.
You, that's what honor your mother and father is about. Not going into church while she make the child molest the rich. And then when you say something about it, they gonna blame you like it's your fault, man. That's why we teaching what God want taught, man. We love blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans in the ISUPK, and the only place where your children will ever be safe to learn about the truth of this Bible is in the ISUPK, man. That's why the Lord sent us out here, man. You don't know what you're missing, man. You don't know the brotherhood that you're missing, man.
Right.
You don't know it's things that you got inside of you that'll teach and that will encourage another black man not to commit a murder.
Right.
That'll encourage a sister not to abort her baby.
Right.
That'll encourage a man not to get high no more, man.
Right.
It'll encourage our people to serve the Lord, man. The same way the Christian church encourages our people to break God's laws.
Right.
That's what the Lord wants.
My manhood.